So welcome everybody. My name is Samson Lee. I'm your host today. And today we're going to have a fantastic leadership training. Now this training is definitely for people with some experience and also people who are into GMS quite a bit already, building their business. So today we have a very, very special person doing the training for us. And there could be nobody better. Because you know, for me, now I have been in the industry for about 5 years. I've seen many, many trainers from all over the world in big conferences. And I will share with you this, really from, not only because she's my friend, but she is one of the really best trainers in the industry, bar none, okay? So without further ado, I'd like to bring up my good friend, mentor, and GMS number one leader, is Kim Wei.
Thanks, Samson. All right. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
You guys look good. Well, we didn't expect a big turnout on a Saturday, on a Sunday afternoon for a leadership. And so today, I mean, I've been pondering and thinking about how can we take this team to the next level. Because as we take this business, now so far, in about a year's time, we have already taken this business. We have set footprints now to over 50 countries. Not too bad, right, in 1 year's time. And so I think it's about time for us leaders to step up, to really to catapult your business to the next level. And not only that, to really set a story. A success story for yourself. And so I see a lot of new faces here, and I hope that you're already in the business, and I also see a lot of familiar faces. And so it's a pleasure for me to do the training here today. And today is not your basic training. Today is really, it's about leadership, stepping up your role to be taking your business to the next level that you want it to go to. And so it is of utmost importance that you look at this business and do this business with the right light, with the right mindset. Because 90% of our business is all based on your mindset and your attitude. Because if you're 1 degree off one day, compounded over time, we're completely off course. And so having said that, let me begin by asking this question. How many of you, and I want you really, I need your imagination, I really need you to work with me on this one. How many of you come into GMS to just make an extra living, an extra few thousand a month? Show of hands. Okay, one or two hands. So now, how many of you came here to make a fortune? Show of hands.
Yes.
Okay, very good. Now, so that's why you're here. That's why I wanted this training to be here. See, it's okay if you want to make a living. It is also okay if you want to make a fortune. But there, the distinction is what you do with the business. See, all of us can be excited, all of us can be motivated when our business is thriving. True or not true? If your team is working, you're thriving, it is very exciting. See, the key is not what you do when your business is up. The challenge comes in your business is what would you do when your business is not where it should be, or when your business is not where it wants to be. It's either it will make you or break you. So today the training may be a little bit strong, and I hope it's okay. I'm a little bit concerned because we're seeing some new faces here, but I do hope that you have been involved in the business for a while, because this is really for the people that have been doing GMS for a while and that you have stepped up to be a leader. And so we ask your local leaders to identify who the top people are, and we want you to be here. So having said that, now I need you to help me out, and I want you to picture, start imagining, what would you do? Now, again, this is a training. There's no guarantee of income in any form, shape, or way. But I want to impose this question and ask you, what would you do if you know that right now you're making $20,000 a month? I want you to have that frame of mind. What would you be doing? What would some of you, and I want you to start thinking about that. What would you do if you were making $20,000 a month? You think $20,000 a month is pretty decent income?
Yes.
In America, I think it's pretty decent. Would you not agree with me?
Yes.
So, I need some of the answers. Now, what would you do? Forget about the recording right now. I need live. I need feedback. I said, this is me. This training is for you. I took out my Sunday. You took out your Sunday. This is for you to get your business to the next level. So I need your participation. So I want some of the feedbacks. What would you do if you're making $20,000 a month?
Quit my job.
Okay, quit his job. Okay. Now, anybody have similar feelings?
Fire
my
boss.
Fire my boss, okay? I don't think she had a boss, okay? But anyway, what would some of you do? And any ideas? What would some of you do?
Help more people.
Okay? And what other things?
Well,
I want to. Work hard, travel. Okay, very good. Now, I want you to start getting those feelings. We all need something to motivate us. We all need something to inspire us to go to the next level in life. If not, do a job. The job pays your daily paycheck, your weekly paycheck, your monthly paycheck. So to get somewhere in life, in your career, you need something that you can latch onto, that you believe that you can get it. Now, so we all established 20 grand is pretty decent income a month. Yep. In America, right?
Right, yes.
My question to you is, if you knew you could do that, if you knew failing is not an option, what are you willing to do to get to $20,000 a month?
Work hard.
Doing whatever it takes. See, over the years, last 18 years, I have worked with thousands, countless people. And every time I go to a meeting, when people get so excited, they go, that's it. I can see it, I can feel it, I'm going to be a big player, and I'm going to make $20,000 a month, or $30,000 a month, or $50,000 a month. But you know what? After a little while, you don't see them no more. Why? Because most people, when they throw a number out, something's got to balance. See, a lot of people want to make a lot of money, and yet not everyone are willing to do whatever it takes to get to your goal. So 20 grand a month, we know in America's decent income. Now most people in America make how much a month? Average? 5,000, 6,000, 7,000, 5,000, 3,000, 4,000, 3,000. Oh my gosh, lower and lower, okay. So let's just say that 5,000 a month. What do most people have to do to make that 4,000 to 5,000 a month?
40 hours
a week, a day, 40 hours a day, no, 8 hours a day for 5 days, right? That'd be 40 hours
a week
to make that, sometimes more. Not mention about the stress that come along with it, not mention about the traffic that comes along with it. So they are willing to do that day in and day out to make the 5,000, 4,000 to 5,000 a month. Now here you are, you set yourself a goal. You want to make 20,000. A month. Are you willing to work harder on your own business than what you put in for your job?
Sure.
See, something's gotta give. Some people say, I wanna make 20, Kim, how do I do what you do? I wanna make 20,000 a month. I said, great, meet me every week, twice a week. Meet me at Rose Meat and meet me at Walnut. They go, that's too far for me. And I said, listen, you wanna make the money, you wanna change your life, something's gotta give. So having said that, we really need to have the right mindset of, do you really, really want it? Do you really, really believe that you can do it?
It is a huge blessing to be making the kind of money that I'm blessed to make. But you know what? Most people don't see the work behind the scenes. See, what it takes to be a leader, this is a leadership training. So I need you to really to step it up. If you really, really want to make the kind of money to step it up. Most people see the money, the glory that we get to get. But most people, and at the same time, they don't see the pain, the tears that came behind the scene. You know, so many times, approximately once a month, I'm traveling on the plane. I spend a lot of time in the lounges at the airport. At 4 o'clock in the morning, in transit, going from country to country, one day, it's 4 o'clock in Hong Kong, in transit from one terminal to another, and I was standing right in front of the fast train. The fast train, there's a mirror, there's a reflection, not a mirror, there's a reflection on the train. You know what I saw? A reflection of myself. Having my carry-on, I said, you know what? It's 4 o'clock in the morning, when most mothers, most wives are at home with the children, with the kid, with the family. And here I was, hopping from country to country. See, there's a price to be paid. Success, you know what? We all heard it. The price for success must be paid in full and upfront. Now, do we get challenges? Absolutely, every single day. But it's what you do with it. It's all mental. It's all mindset. You know, I give you a perfect story, and I don't think I've shared with anyone. I was recently on a 14-day trip, 5 countries, 14-day trip. And one of my trip was right before I went to Taiwan for the grand opening. I was in China. I was in Shenzhen. And I was all day long trip, meeting after meeting, meeting after meeting. Tina doesn't even know this. It was with her team. She doesn't even know what went on. And when I came back, I was too busy to deal with what we got faced. See, I want to share with you how you deal with this type of business, okay? So when I was in China and I was so tired, it was like 2 o'clock in the morning. We were at a spa. And a whole entourage of people at the spa. It's a 7-story spa, okay? So we were there getting ready to get a massage. And I was so tired, and there's a team of people from Hong Kong, a team of people from Taiwan, a team of people from China. They were there. And so the team of people from Hong Kong said, Kim, you know what? We just had the event in Hong Kong. We'd like to sit down with you. We'd like to strategize. We'd like to discuss what went on and how we can improve it, how we can do better. And I told them, I said, you know what? I would love to, but simply, my brain's just fried. I mean, it's just been a long, long day hopping, you know, from Hong Kong to Shenzhen. I said, listen, can we do another day? So it was 2 o'clock in the morning. I said, is it okay if I just get a massage and I just chill out a little bit? And they go, sure. And my eyes like a panda. I was like, ready to drop out. And so while I was walking by going to my room for treatment, I passed by a group of people. They're from China. I said, oh, Kim, sit down. It was like a big cafeteria, you know, like this 7-story spa. You know, first story, you checked in. Second story, you take a shower. Third story, you get your foot massage. Fifth story, you get your body massage and Thai massage, Chinese massage, whatever massages, okay? So I was ready to go to my treatment, and the group of people said, Kim, would you sit down? And I was so, so dead tired. I said, they go, please, you know, you're leaving soon, would you sit down? So I sat down. So in the midst of me falling asleep, dozing off, something happened during the meeting amongst the people in the meeting. Guess what happened? They started pounding on the table. I go, this is a spa. And they start pounding the table and fighting start going on. And here I was. While awake, when they were all fighting, pouncing on the table, I said, what is this? I come from America. I'm not used to this, okay? And I was while awake. I ended up spending time with them from pounding, fighting, until everybody hugging and laughing. It took until 4 o'clock in the morning. Then the people from Hong Kong, they come look for me. They're just, you know, browsing around looking for something to eat, not looking for me. They saw me. They said, we thought you didn't want to spend time with us because you were so tired. I said, listen, you don't want to know what happened, okay? I was wide awake. The reason why I want to share the story with you is this. See, most people, even though you guys override a team, some of you override a team in your team, you don't even know what happened. See, in order for you to realize what goes on in the business, you really got to travel with me. Not only travel with me, to be in the trenches, in the field. Then you really got a feel of what really goes on. It's fun. Don't get me wrong. I just want to prepare you. So the reason why I want to share this with you is this. We as leaders, when we step into a situation, we got to deal with things. And what happens when we're done with it, when I came back, I never even told the story. This is one of hundreds of stories that I travel. But when I came back, guess what I deal with? Whatever the people, we have to be present with the people that we're working with. See, we as leaders, we must rise above the occasion. How you know, whether you succeed or not with this business, it depends on how you deal with the business. Most people in this business, you know what to do? They major in minors. They may put all their attention on the minor stuff. Minor stuff challenges, do we have it? You think Coca-Cola, IBM, Apple, do you think they have issues? Yes. Every day. But it's how we deal with it. So what are we supposed to do? We are leaders. What are we supposed to do? We must get good at mastering the basics. Okay? So besides having the right attitude, now this is come on maybe quite strong to some of you, but this is very important. You as a leader, first, you gotta have that belief. Do you really believe you could do it? If you believe you could do it, look, listen. We have dug gold from it. You know, you have no idea last week. When I heard Tina, when I heard Winnie, Samson, when they're making the money, you have no idea how good I felt. You know, it's that joy. I mean, you know, people say, Kim, you're making so much money. Why are you working so hard? Because I want to see the people that join me, that work hard with me. When they make the kind of money I do, I say, you know what? Then I can retire. Because most people, and I could tell you one thing. With this team, I don't care what company you go into in the industry. Of direct selling, you can go to any company. I challenge you. You can go to any company. You will never, ever find the leaders that we have in this team that care so much, that dedicate so much of their time and their love. I will challenge any one of you. You go to any MLM company. You won't find the leadership that we have on this team because it is a family for us. It is a passion. So we as leaders, we got to step it up. You want to make 20 grand a month. Okay, that's all great. That's fine. It's a noble goal. But you know what? Be willing to do what it takes to get to 20 grand a month. Are you guys with me so far? So what is mastering the basics, okay? We have to learn to master, you know. People say they want to get fancy. No, there's no need to get fancy. You got to get good at the simple stuff. So what is the simple stuff that we gotta be good at? One, you gotta be very good at piquing interest. Now, what is piquing interest? Piquing interest is simply asking people that if they have an option, are they open to have to possibly change their lives, to probably have financial freedom? You just pique their interest. Now, later on, we're gonna have a series of different basic trainings, so teaching about how you pique interest using what we call form. Okay, piquing interest is nothing more than you try to identify your prospect's needs. And what you do is you provide a solution. How are you gonna find out what their needs are? Let's say Luz, if you know Luz, you know, you gotta get to know her. Yeah, these are your prospects, you know their background. Let's say Luz is a realtor. Let's say Luz is a great realtor. Realtor might make good money at a certain time period, but guess what most realtors have to do? They go from deal to deal. You make a sale, you make some commission. Guess what? In order for her to make money again, she had to go on, knock on doors again, move on a deal. Car salesman, same thing, right? You make a sale, you sell a car, next month, your quota, you start from zero all over again. So you have to identify what their needs are, what their wants are, through what we call form, okay? That's a whole different training, okay? So form meaning F stands for family. You know, how's your family? You need to find out what their needs are, what their wants are. So talk about their family. How are your family? How are the kids? So through your asking the questions, you are able to identify what their wants and what the needs and what the desires are, okay? Now, F stands for family, O stands for occupation. How's your job? R stands for recreation, your vacation, you know, have you done anything fun lately? What have you traveled to recently? The reason you want to say all this, ask all this stuff, is that through that form, you're able to find out what is it that they may be lacking, maybe they're looking to improve on. M stands for money. How's your financial situation? And I tell you, there's not a better time to recruit people than now. The economy, so many people are being downsized. So many people are being laid off. And this is a great, great timing for you to build your business and really offer a solution to other people, okay? So pique interest, simply ask them, are you open? Might you be open to possibility? That is it. It's not asking, will you join me in Jeunesse? No, you are not asking to join you anything. You are piquing their interest to see if they're piquing, meaning to see if there's an interest for them to even go a step further. Okay? So pique interest and learn to use it through form. Okay? Second thing you gotta get good at is inviting them to our events. Once you pique the interest and they are open, instead of you sit there and blah, 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 all about Luminesse and all about Reserve, your job is to invite them to one of our local events. We're lucky, we have events going on right here. For people, now what is an event? This is very important. What is an event? An event could be a local meeting, okay? An event also could be what? A one-on-one session with your upline, a one-on-one, okay? Or a small PBR at your house. If you have a home presentation, PBR stands for Private Business Reception. Okay? Or it could be a webinar. For people that are far away from us, it could be a webinar. Okay? Now, also it could be a conference call. And pretty soon, we are going to have a DVD, an opportunity DVD. Okay? OPP, Opportunity Presentation DVD. That if they're interested, all you do is you pop them a DVD, say, watch this, and zip the lip. Because too often, too many times, people start, they ask you, oh, what is it? Then you start, blah, 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 blah. Until they are so bored, they go, okay, forget it. Because it's too hard of a sale for me, okay? So you need to invite them to and plug them into the event. Now, why is it so important to plug your people into the event? How many of you would like to retire? Just work the business 2 to 3 years and really retire. How many of you want that? See, if you want to retire, we got to leverage on the system. And the key thing to our business is what? The one thing, if we forget anything today at all, is called duplication. How do you duplicate yourself? Because see, some of you in this room, you are super kings and queens on one-on-ones. Anybody you sit down with, you close them. To me, signing them is simple. Getting them to sign up and go to work
it's a whole different issue. See, you want to sign them up and you want to give them a vehicle to go and duplicate you so that they don't always rely on you. See, a lot of people in this business, when you make yourself the issue, we can't succeed. Because you know why? We can never retire. Because it's always about you. If you stop doing one-on-one, guess what happened to your business? It dies. It stops. So you need to, how you duplicate is you need to, if you forget anything at all, you got to get good at plugging your people to the events. You must be able to learn. You have to learn to promote the events. So how you promote, invite people to events, and you as a leader, you need to learn to promote events. You have to learn to sell events because, see, through the events, you know what they will learn? They will begin to gain confidence. They will begin to have belief. Every single one of you guys' groups, I know what happened. See, the team that always plug into the meetings, I know they're growing. The teams that don't plug in the meeting, even though got big sales, you know what, a month or two later, when any small challenge happens, guess what happened? Completely collapsed, dies. So you have to get good at promoting event. Don't let language or culture be a barrier. Some people say, you know what? No, Chinese, they don't understand anything. I say, I don't care if they understand anything, but they understand body language. They understand people. They go, whoa, so many people. There must be something good going on. You guys with me so far? Yeah. You gotta get good. See, when people come in the meeting, after the meeting, guess what happens? They don't even understand. They go, wow, all those people. You pull them in the corner, you say, you see all those people? Then you can show them briefly what it's all about. But, you know, I also know that some of the people's mentality goes like this. They themselves have their own blockage. They say, you know what, I can't get my people to the meeting. Or my type of people don't like to go to meetings. We got to get good at overcoming that. Because I knew, all this last 18 years, everything I shared with you, I went through myself. I always tell my sponsor before, he says, Kim, you are a queen of one-on-one. You go out there, you sign up people, you go out and sign up people, you're really good. But you know what? I discovered something. I can never stop. Because if I stop, I don't make any money. And I told my sponsor, I said, you know why I can't promote meeting? Because my type of people, they're professionals, they don't like MLM. They don't like MLM meeting. They don't like environment. They just don't like that kind of environment. Kim, until the day you yourself get over that blockage, otherwise you can't promote events. You won't succeed. Because it was all in my mindset. But you know what? Once I overcame that mindset in the meeting, you know, now, I mean, you guys know I come from Hong Kong, so I could say that. I'm from Hong Kong. And I say, Hong Kong people are very fast. They just want all the facts, and they don't want to sit through the meeting. And that was always I tell people. But you know what? Boy, was I wrong. Until I changed my mindset, when it was a meeting, I packed the most people from Hong Kong, from San Francisco, packed the whole Hong Kong people. Why? Because when I had the belief to promote the event, people would come. You got to promote like a movie, okay? You have to learn how do you promote events. To promote the event, you have to edify the information. Either edify the speaker or edify the information. You edify the heck out of it, I'm telling you. Don't edify it like an MLME thing, but edify it like an opportunity that can literally change their life. If you talk with that belief, when you promote events, you gotta learn to edify, and you have to have that belief. You say, listen, if I can show you something, I can invite you to a meeting, an event, if that 2 hours of your time, if it could change your life, it could possibly help turn your financial situation around, would you invest 2 hours of your time?
Yes.
Of course, right? Now, if they say no, that means do not continue. Don't fight with them. Move on. If you know, but see, there is a fine line. If you talk like not sure, you're not quite sure about the meeting, and when you promote like that, people can feel you. But if you say, listen, all I ask for is 2 hours of your time. Because if you didn't like it, just pretend you watch a bad movie. But if you like it, it might be something. It might be something that could turn your life around. All I ask for 2 hours. And after the 2 hours, I won't buck you no more. Why is it important for them to come in? When they come to a meeting, guess what? They hear testimonials. They see other people's. Guess what? When they do that, the business is no longer about you. Because it's always you talking to people. It's okay, it's good to have a lot of one-on-ones. It's great to have small meetings, home meetings. But after the home meeting, after the one-on-ones, what's your goal? Your number one goal is to promote the event. The next event,
We build from event to event. It's called impending events. Okay? So, because people are always looking for what's next. So you sign up now. Your job is next time I want you to come to a meeting, you meet some of my business partners. So you get to learn from people what this business is all about, because I'm telling you, there is something magical when it comes to events. I literally built my entire business through events. Now speaking of events, we have a major event coming up. If you really want to test this program to see if it works for you, in my 18 years, it's proven to work each and every time. This is proven. The system is proven. Don't try to do it your own way until you succeed. If you want to try to test it, this coming event, the company has a super event at St. Gabriel Hilton. Whoever can bring the most people from your team, either your prospect or your team's prospect, whoever bring the most people will be the most successful. Because there's something magical when you get the people into the situation, into the meeting environment. Are you guys with me so far?
Yes.
So you got to master basics and you have to learn to promote the event. And you got to really believe. Remember I told you, when you want something bad enough and you believe you'll get it, you will do all our massive action to make changes in your life. Because so did I, okay? And I'm going to share with you a story later about that, okay? So how do you edify the information? Now, this one thing, another, the basics, pique interest, learn how to invite people to the event, and teach your people to plug into the system, okay? And you yourself got to be willing to put in some time to the meetings that we have.
Get good at is
learn how to edify, okay? What is edification? Edify meaning speaking good of somebody, okay? Now, so in that, I will explain this to you. We have what we call the A, B, C. What is A? A is the experts. Who is the expert? Anybody but you. Always remember that. Most people let themselves be the expert. I don't care what your past history, I don't care whatever you did big in the past. We're dealing with the now. We got to be willing to drop the ego, drop the past to succeed in this business, okay? Now, the A is the expert. Who is the expert again? Anybody but
you.
That's right. Anybody but us, okay? Now, B is you, okay? You are the person in the business. Who is C? C is the prospect. Now, between you and your prospect, hopefully you guys have trust. Hopefully your prospect trusts you, okay? When you say go this way, hopefully your prospect won't go the other way, okay? So hopefully they trust you. Now, what is your job to do? Your job is to edify the experts. Why you need to edify the experts? The reason why you want to edify the expert is so that prospect will respect. So the prospect will have respect to A. Because if you say nothing about the expert, the expert just shows up, they go, who are you? Why should I even listen to you? Are you guys with me so far? So if you could learn to edify, just the edification process, you can literally build your entire business. Because edification ties into promoting events. So when you not only do you edify a person, you can edify the event. An event is something that you must. You know what? Events are lifeline of your business. It's the oxygen, the environment that we need to breathe. See, is it true that in the outside environment there's a lot of negativities out there? True or not true? There's a lot. Doesn't matter what business we do. So, and we gotta give people an environment so people feel nurtured so they can grow and work in the environment. And how we do that is by plugging them into the event so that it's not based on you, okay? Now, so your job is to edify the expert. Now, what do you say about the expert? Who is the expert? Anybody but you. And I tell you, to my family, each and every single one of you are experts. I cannot tell my family to use Lumines, but Tina can ask my dad to use Lumines. I cannot tell my father to take reserve, but you know what? Samson can tell my dad to take reserve. How? It's just the human beings, human nature. Why? I don't know. How many of you heard that the saying that the grass is greener on the other side? It's the out-of-town prophet mentality.
Yeah.
Because, you know, the prophet in his own town is not of much use until they travel abroad, okay, or somewhere else. That's just the nature. So your job is to edify. Like, perfect example. We had breakfast with my parents with Tina. And I was telling my mom and dad. Because I told my mom that a long time. I told my mom, Mom, you had a big eye bag. Put luminous in your eyes. It's going to help you. Wouldn't even touch it. Okay? So Tina was right there. I said, Mom, Tina had a lot of success in luminous. And her people, her team is very successful using luminous. You know, and Tina just showed my mom the hand. And guess what happened? My mom started using luminous on her face. But it took me like months. I couldn't get my own mother to use luminous. But it took someone else. Why? I tee up Tina. I have to edify. What is edify? Edify meaning you tee up somebody. It doesn't have to be somebody make a lot of money. No. It could be, you just tee up some good characteristics of that person. It could be that person have a golden heart, a heart of gold. Or it could be that person's very successful in their own rights, in their own business. If some of you might have noticed, when I introduce people to other people, I always find the best of the best of that person. And I will tell that story to whoever I'm introducing. What am I doing? I'm teeing up that person. Because in business, when you have trust plus respect, you know what you get? You got a sale. You got to have trust and respect. Most of you came into Jeunesse because someone told you about it. If I were to go, look, if I were to go to car wash, if I were to go to a gas station, and you don't know me from Adam. I just came up to you and said, listen, you got to try this adult stem cell thing. You got to try resveratrol. You might think I'm nuts. You might run away from me. But if somebody had teed me up or teed you up to be the expert, now, you don't have to be expert on products. No, you could be the expert on anything. Do you understand what I'm saying? So you tee up some good characteristic so that when this person talks, guess what happens? The prospect will listen because there's respect. Are you guys with me so far? Yeah. So we need to get very good at edification. I have people that literally built a nationwide organization by learning to edify the person they're working with. See, in this business, you are in business for yourself, right? But not by yourself. Because you have your upline or the upline leader, the upline expert to work with you to help you build your business. So you have to understand the relationships amongst the people, because this is a people business. So the third thing you have to learn is really edify. Now edify, don't go at a lie, okay? Edify means tell the truth about whoever that person you're working with. They might be a nurse, they might be a business owner, because you know why? Most people have the ideology of business owner makes a whole lot of money, okay? Sometimes it's true. But what most people don't realize that a lot of times, especially the economy like this, business owners are suffering. Because before they make a dime, they have all this overhead. They have the fixed overhead to pay before they even pocket the money. A lot of business owners nowadays, their staff, their employee are making more money than they themselves. The next thing we have to do is you yourself as leaders have to be good at meeting conducts. Meeting conducts, what are they? We all know that in a meeting environment, that's where we do business, right? So having said that, it's very important for us as leaders to arrive on time, not late, to arrive on time, if not early, okay? Meeting conduct is to arrive on time and to help out. I mean, look, this meeting is for you guys. I mean, I tell you, from day one, when my sponsor told me, whoever holds a marker, whoever helps set up the room, are the ones that make the most money. I was the first one to volunteer. I said, show me. Just teach me how. So this meeting, whenever I go to a meeting, the first thing I do, you guys are leaders. I mean, that's why when I say leadership meeting, please, please don't bring any new people. Because when you have new people, I can't cover some of the stuff, okay? When a meeting like this, any meeting, any event, what's the first thing you need to look for? To make sure the event is all set up. If not, you need to take charge and get it to set up. Because why? The meeting, the event is for whom? And not for you. For whom? For your prospect. Okay? So you got to come early and take pride. Take charge. Don't just, oh, it's not my team. I'm sitting here and slouching. No. Because maybe right now it's not your team. Eventually it may be your team. It will be your team. Okay? Now, the other thing is it's very important. You are leaders. Please participate. Okay? Because participation is key. What do I mean by participation? When the speaker asks you, how many people would like to make some money? Show of hands. Yeah. That's really exciting, you know, okay? So let's try one more time. And how many of you would like to make some money? Yeah. Show of hands. See, I tell you, I don't need you to fake and hoo-hoo-hoo. No need for that. But when you participate genuinely, guess what? That excitement, that enthusiasm is contagious of people around you. I was taught a long time ago that a lot of this make you a lot of money, okay? I said, just show me how to do it. I will clap the loudest you want me to clap. And I actually had invented a way to clap really loud, okay? It's like going like this. But anyway, I won't go there today. So you got to do a lot of this, a lot of this. We got to participate because the meet is not for you. It's for whom? For the people sitting next to you, for your prospect. This is very important. Now, this is leadership. I need you to crack a smile. Because it's not easy to be up here, guys. When you're up here, you realize one of these days when you do a meeting and Rick is nodding, he's like, yeah, it's really nerve-wracking sometimes. And you know what? The speaker is only as good as the audience. So we need you. When you're sitting down, kind of crack a smile because we need that smile. We need the energy to feed the audience. So, and because if you're like no expression face, please, I we need that from you, each and every single one of you. Because if, let's say that you have a prospect sitting next to you. If the speaker says, how many of you would like to make some extra money? And your prospect, don't raise a hand, you're not your prospect, you do, come on, you know? See, because by you doing that, it becomes fun. It becomes a whole gelling environment. So I couldn't emphasize enough, I need that from you. And then also, very important, the meeting conducts, when you come, please sit down with your prospect in the front. Unless we're totally packed, usually we're packed now. So if we're packed, then you can give the seat to the prospect. But do sit next to your prospect. I see a lot of people over the years, you know what they do? They sit their prospect in the front. They go, you sit here, okay? I'm gonna hang back there with the big players. No, you sit there with them. You know why? When you sit there with your prospect, you know what your prospect likes and what he or she doesn't like. When your prospect doing a lot of this, you know what they're doing? They're buying. Okay, so you need to be with them so you can be participating. You can, it becomes contagious with your prospect. So it's very important you sit with them. Now, if you are sitting in the front, it's very important that don't save seats. Because when you save seats, guess what happened? The meeting starts, your prospect don't show up, we have a couple of empty seats, and then you know what happened? During the meeting, the person sitting, you're sitting in the front, you keep looking back to see if your prospect had came. First, if your prospect actually walked up, it'll be interruptive to people around them. Second, if you're sitting in the front, you keep looking back, guess what the people behind you will do? Yeah. They all look back. And it could be that very same word that the speaker would say. It could be that key phrase, that concept, that thoughts, that idea the speaker spoke about. Then when everybody turned, it could be that very same thing that helped close the deal. So it's very important that you sit in the front with the prospect, and when you're sitting in the front, if you're expecting people, please, 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 when the meeting starts, don't keep looking back. If you keep looking back, the whole crowd will go with you, okay? So these are the very little things, but it makes a world of difference, and you gotta be get good at really participating, okay? And so these are some of the stuff, and you know, the other thing is get good at how to close. After you took the time, you invite your prospect to an event, into any meeting, and then they come. At the end of the meeting, you know what I see some people do? They get up, they go, oh, go, let's go to my house. We go, or let's go eat. And then you take everybody, you start leaving the room. After the meeting, if you get up, guess what the people next to you do? They will get up. After the meeting, what you do is you grab a chair, you form a little circle, and you face them. And please have your application ready. You can download it from the website. You guys, we're independent business owners. That means you got to learn to be independent, but at the same time, plug into the system. So many times, after the meeting, I need an application. Do you have an application? Please, have your own. Can we do that? This is your tool. This is your business. How many have seen people do that? Maybe you yourself are guilty. Okay? So please, we need to have application. Download, make some copy. Because unless you have online internet, and I suggest when you start making some money, really get a Wi-Fi computer that has a internet card. and then you can start enrolling people online. But it's much faster, you have an application. So how to close? After the meeting, don't have a habit of taking them home. What you do is form a circle, face them. Louis, wasn't it great? Which package did you like best? That's right. Now, I do not say, what do you think? If I say, hey, Louis, what do you think? You know what she'll say? Oh, let me think about it. It's kind of interesting. How many of you heard that? Oh, give me some time, yeah. Yeah, let me go home and check with my husband, okay? So I usually don't ask them what they think. I only ask them, what do you like best about it? Which program did you like best? Okay, now, if she said, well, I think, you know, I'm not too sure about which one. And I said, well, I can tell you what, from a professional opinion, what you could do is you can, you know, if you really look at this as a business, you should, the minimum thing you should do is to start with a jumbo program. So you can get some product and you can, you know, share with family. And they go, oh, that sounds interesting. I said, okay, great. Let me show you how to get started. Then I get my application and I said, now, when they send out the check, what name do you want to be put under? Why? Because you want to ping an idea. What name would you like the check to go to? They go, me, mine, okay? Very few will say, go to my husband or my spouse, okay? So you go, okay, Mike, your name are great. Now, what address would you like your check to be sent to? The address, right? Okay, great. Then your day of birth. Now, the last part I will ask is social, because people are very sensitive about social. Uh-huh. Now, so trust me, don't worry about proceeding. Some people say, oh, what if they say no? I said, listen, if they say no, they will let you know anyways. If you get to them and say, okay, great, let's say you proceed with the information. Okay, what is your social? So the company, at the end of the year, if you make more than $600, they'll 1099 you. Okay, they put it right there. And don't worry, afterwards, I can shred it or I can let you take it home. Okay, the application. So great. Now, I need your autograph right here. I don't say I need you to sign. Because usually when you say sign, that means read. They're going to read a whole bunch of stuff, okay? So I would say I need your autograph right there. And then when it comes to payment, I will usually say, now, would you like to put that on your MasterCard or your Visa? I don't say, how would you want to pay for it? No. You do the assumptive close. Are you guys with me so far? Yeah. Would you like to put it on your MasterCard or your Visa? Now, a lot of times people say, oh, okay, I'll put it on my Visa, MasterCard. Now, when people say, well, I'm not ready. If they, by then they're not ready, it is okay. They will tell you anyway. If they're not ready, say, great. Can I help you answer some of your objections? What are some of the things that prevent you from getting ready? What are some of the things that's keeping you back? Then when you ask a closing question, what do you do? See, a lot of times when people ask, for example, which program do you like lose? And then when the prospect's quiet, guess what they start doing? They start yakking. Oh, you know what? You really should go with the basic or the jumbo, blah, 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 blah. When you, remember, after you ask a closing question, whoever speaks the first loses. When you ask a closing question, which package you like more? Now, if a silent game going on, it's okay. Let them think. And that's going. I wait. A lot of people cannot tolerate silence. I wait and I smile. If they have questions, they ask me anyways. So many times, people are so afraid to close. Why are the prospect? You know, like, let's say, for example, and this is me. I'm telling you, 18 years ago, this is me. My sponsor was a tall Chinese guy, and I had six people right there. And after the meeting, he was right there handing all my prospect application. And I go, it's okay. You know, I said, you know, I'll take care of them. I'll take them home and I'll take care of them. And he like, if look can kill, he will kill me. Okay? And he started asking questions. He won't let them go. He started asking questions, filling the app. And I felt so uncomfortable with it. I said, they're not ready. Let them go home. Let them think about it. And so they will let me know. Guess what happened to six of them? They thought about it. Never came back. Yeah. Okay? Because you know why? Human nature. A lot of times, because there's a lot of opposition to MLM. And a lot of misunderstanding about MLM. And the very minute they leave here, when they deal with the real world outside, guess what happened? Their friends and relatives and out of the kindness of their heart, they thought they knew MLM. They thought they knew the industry. They thought they had experience. There's many experts out there. So whenever, oh, lucky you, you didn't sign up that day. If you sign up, man, you'd be one of those people that got sucked into the game. They go, oh, thank goodness. Then from then on, whenever you try to call them back, they never pick up the phone no more. Because why? other people got to them. Those are called dream stealers that steal them away. Okay? So I tell you what, people, some of you might be uncomfortable doing closing. Trust me, if they are not ready, they would have told you, I'm not ready. If they're not ready, great. What are some of the things that I can do to help answer your objections? What are some of the things, the questions that you have? If I can answer, now some people will start throwing questions at you, one after another. And when it gets to a point, you know, there are people that will ask you questions just to ask you questions. So if they start asking you one question, and then second question, by the third question, I say, listen, if I can answer all of your questions tonight to your satisfaction, will you get started with me? If they say no, I'm not ready, I say, you know what, come back when you're ready to make a decision, then I will sit down and to whatever it takes, I'll answer all of your questions. Because there's no sense to sit there all day, all night, answering all the questions, because you already prefaced it to them. You said, listen, if I can answer all of your questions to your satisfaction, will you be able to make a decision and get started with me?
Sure.
And if they say sure, then you take whatever time it takes to answer their question. If they say no, not really, then I will say to them like this. I said, listen, you know what, that's okay. Whenever you're ready to make a decision, once all your questions are answered, when you're at that stage in your life, then you come to me. See why? If people respect you more when you respect your own time. Because you sit there and you all day, no use. You know, I remember when I started working with Samson and started working with Robert, you know what those two guys would do? They would travel all over Los Angeles area. They would do training after training after training. And I said, where's the body? I said, where are all these people? Oh, they haven't joined yet. I said, why? You doing free volunteer work? I said, why are you training people when they before they even get started? You don't get paid for doing that. So, you know, this just when you start respecting your own time, your own business, then other people will respect it, okay? So it's very important to go for close. Now, why is it important to go for close? I'll give the story to you. Once upon a time, there's a very rich, rich Texan. I mean, he lives in Texas, multi-gazillionaire, okay? And he's a little bit bored with life, and he wanted to do some experiments. So he has a big, huge Olympic-sized pool, and he decided to throw a big, huge party. But the night before the party, he decided to throw a lot of alligator and water moccasin in the pool, okay? A bunch of them. So the next day, when the party begins, when the guests start arriving, a lot of people start arriving, so he gathered everybody at the pool, around the pool. And he would say, listen, whoever is daring enough to jump into the pool and able to swim across the pool and come up alive, I will grant him or her anything he or she want in life. Before he even stopped talking that, he heard a loud splash. There was a guy in the pool. And the guy was like on an Olympic record, you know, because why? Because water moccasin and alligators chasing on his tail. So he was swimming across the pool in record time. He came up from the pool, all, you know, shaking all the water, and this multi-billionaire walked up to him, so excited, run up to him, said, sir, can you tell me what it is that you want? I will give you anything you want in life. And this guy says, before you give me anything I want in life, I want to find out the name of that dude who pushed me into the pool. So sometimes